this place is so great. You just look out the window and you just see, you know, the promise of the future. When I see you guys walking around, and I do, you know, from up here and as I walk across campus, that's a fascinating thing to me, is I say to myself, here's these young people, kids, you guys are referred as, you're gonna take over here in about 10, 15, 20 years. You know, you're gonna be that generation of people that will be watching on TV as the leaders in, whether it's journalism or government or corporate America, whatever it is, or the arts. And we have you right here, and we could have the President of the United States walking around for all we know. So that's a fascinating thing to me, is the potential that I know you all have. Anytime that I am in commencement, as I shake people's hands, you know, people always comment to me later, boy, you smiled the entire, you know, 2.5 hours. I just, I get giddy with that, seeing people coming up and seeing that they're nervous and shaking their hand, and they're just absolutely, you know, beaming because of the accomplishment of walking through that stage after 4 or 5 or whatever number of years, the sacrifices that you make. It brings me back memories to when I was a student, and it is a sacrifice. You know, a lot of our students, you know, work outside of, you know, school, and their families maybe are sacrificing, or maybe they're the first in their family to go to college, and what it means to actually walk through that stage and get that diploma. So that's by far the biggest thrill, but, you know, short-term kind of thrills, the sports. Mm-hmm. I love seeing our Lady Aggies, you know, beat teams that don't even expect it. So I couldn't help myself, you know, much to the chagrin of my staff. I rushed the court just like everybody else. You just couldn't see me because I'm barely 5 feet tall, but the pressure is in trying to decide the priorities of all that you need to do, and what goes first, what goes second, and so forth, to try to maximize those resources, which, you know, incidentally, a lot of them come from our students and our parents. We've got to be extremely good stewards of that money. One of the statistics that I love to tell people is that in all the public institutions in Texas, we have the lowest administrative cost ratio, 4.1%, meaning 4.1% of our budget is what actually goes into administration to run the university. And the state average is 11%. So we pride ourselves in being very fiscally tight. And it is so that we can release as much of the resources to actually get the programs done, as opposed to, you know, running the university. But that is the most pressure, trying to decide what do we do with what we have so that we maximize the success of the outcome. There's probably some people, I believe that they're in the very, very small minority. We have very sophisticated students here who understand that, you know, here we are, the year 2009, well into the 21st century. Having a woman leader should not be anything novel. You know, it is for us here at A&M because I'm the first, obviously, but you look around corporate America, other universities, you know, they have women presidents. And I think, yeah, sure, there may be some people that maybe haven't gotten used to that idea and are maybe on a wait and see attitude towards, you know, whether a woman can be a good president, can be a good leader. And I understand the responsibility I have to demonstrate them that absolutely. And I hope to be the first of many.